here. She would like to help us out on stage.
Me too.
We've got some way back here. I saw there in the stripes. Please come on up. Yes, come on over. We're going to have this lady right here. Come on over to the stripes. What's your name? Tori. Tori, come on over. Let's run the bus for Tori. Tori, welcome to the show right on over here. Thank you for joining us. Tori, you and I are going to try some magic.
Yeah.
The best selling toy. You brought a pants section. That's awesome. The best selling toy of all time. Tori, it's also the most frustrating toy of all time. Rubik's Cube. Very good. Yes, who's tried to solve a Rubik's Cube before? A couple of you. Tori, have you tried it? You fail. I'm going to give you the secret. Everyone, the secret. The hardest part of solving a Rubik's Cube is once you get the stickers peeled off to get them lined up center again. It's a joke. Yeah, Tori. There are 43 quintillion different ways to turn a Rubik's Cube. That number is so big, you can turn it one time like that every second for over 65 million years and still not get all the different combinations. The guy who invented it was a guy by the name of Erno Rubik back in 1974. When he invented the cube, he actually thought it might be impossible to solve. If he thought it was impossible to solve, he'd be amazed to see something like this. Like five people are impressed. Second cube, I know. Now, the first thing people think is that this cube is fixed in some way, that it can spring back into place. It's not the case. This time I want you to mix it up, okay? Mix and turn, every time that she does, it's a different one of 43 quintillion different possibilities. I have another paper bag back here. You keep on turning, I don't want to see what you're doing. All right, yep. Don't try to solve it, just get it all mixed up. This is going to be unbelievable. You got it? Cool? Excellent. All I have to do, Tori, is take a quick look at it. Cool. Place it inside. Snap of the fingers, it comes out once again. Completely solved. That time there was a second cube. But that would have been amazing. Tori, take a cube. Like this. Usually when people think of a solid Rubik's Cube, this is what they think of, solid colors on every side. I'm going to try to show you a different way to solve the cube. Lift up your hand again. Stay right there. Cover back up. 25, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, no, 26, 27, 27, I think that might be a solved cube. Tori, it doesn't look like it at the moment, but the one that you mixed up, check this out. That is sign number one. There is sign number two. Tori, it's hard to see all the stickers in the back. We got three, right? There is sign three.
Yeah.
Sign four right there. The bottom makes five. Yes. The top makes six. That is a perfect match. That's pretty good. Your turn, Tori. Your turn to solve. I don't want you to turn it like I just did here. What I just showed you takes years and years of practice. Okay, you're going to solve it by magic. You're going to face the audience. You're going to put your hands behind the back. I'm going to hand you the cube. You're going to turn it like I'm doing now. You see what I'm doing? I know it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. You can put a Rubik's Cube behind your back and turn it and get it to solve. But, well, that's what a magic show is all about. Okay, face your audience. Hands behind your back, just like I was showing you. There you go. Start to make it just like I was showing you. Exactly. Turn that cube and think every time you turn it gets closer and closer to being solved. Okay? Tori, whenever you want to, leave your hands behind your back. Whenever you want to, stop turning. Just tell me when he stops. He stopped? Take a guess about how many times did you turn it?
15.
About 15 times. She took a mixed up cube, put it behind her back, turned it about 15 times. Tori, I think you needed to turn it 16 times. Bring it out from behind your back and show it to everybody just like it is. Do one more. That's 16. That's a solid cube. It's Tori. Fantastic job. Hey, Tori?
Yeah?
Don't tell anyone how you did that, okay? Yeah, the secret's safe with you. I can tell from here. She had no clue as it was. Here comes the rock. Thank you.
Hearts, And so this wasn't even really a card trick at all. He caught a piece of paper. Could you stand up? Marcella, stand up. Come on up here. Stand up. Come on up here. You don't have to come all the way out to the stage. You see, you guys have those pieces of paper. Stand right here, sweetie. And he thought you were making all these choices on your own. It was actually already made for you. Yeah, come on over here. Take out your backpack. Go ahead and open up your pieces of paper. Open them up. Something's going to be written on it. Face the audience. Face the audience. Something's going to be written on it. On the count of three, you're going to hold that up above your head and show it to everybody. One, two, three. Hold up and show it. Ace of Hearts. That is unbelievable. Let's hear it for them. All of you a magic trick. This is one that you can do at any sort of party. I'm trying to give you insight once again into how to do some magic.
I'm going to keep on picking on you. A safety pin, hold on to that. We'll get to that in a moment. A deck of cards, they are all different.
I'll teach you exactly how this one is done.
I'll show it to you first. I will go through the cards. You say stop.
Stop. Take the card.
Hold it up in the air, let everybody see it.
Make sure you take a look at it as well. Don't let me see it. You know what it is? Cool. Put it back on the top.
Check this out. Michael, I'm going to take those cards and shuffle them up. I'm going to try to read your mind. You concentrate on the card that you chose, okay? I got an idea. I have a balloon here. You just grab a balloon off of a wall if you're at a party and you can do the trick.
Michael, what card did you choose? Jack of Clubs. Watch. Take one card invisibly out of the deck. Place it inside the balloon. You kind of hear it rattling around there. Open up that safety pin, please. Open up that safety pin. We're going to see if we can get one card. One card to go. One card to go and see. Go and pop the balloon. See?
Okay, I got to take it again.
This one is super, super simple. All you have to do is have someone select a card, in this case the Jack of Clubs, and put it back in the top. Here comes the secret. As I'm shuffling up those cards, I'll give you the backstage view. I'll turn that Jack of Clubs around. I squeeze the cards, and when I do so, the Jack of Clubs never leaves the top of the deck. You kind of see it back there. Jack of Clubs always stays on the top. Then when I ask Michael the card, as I try to
read his mind, all I did was slip that card off and place it inside of my hand.
It's a magician's call palm. You go inside, you grab a balloon, you hold that card up against the inside of the balloon so that no one can see it, and you have someone pop it, and it looks like magic. It's really cool. If you try this for yourself, don't use a clear balloon.
Okay.
It kind of ruins everything. You like see it held up inside like that. You gotta hold your arm at a weird angle. If you do like that, you gotta take it another step and see if I can actually heat up the balloon. Heat up the balloon enough and the Jack of Clubs can actually penetrate inside a little bit more. The Jack of Clubs actually go all the way inside.
I don't know how he got in there.
Michael, come on up here, man. You've been helping me out the entire show. I got a gift for you. It's your very own magic wand. He was excited. Yes, it is exciting. Your very own magic wand, Michael, wiggle your fingers in the wand. It goes flying up into the air. Check it out. Little wiggles. It goes flying up the air. After the show, meet me over here and I'll teach you how to make the jump. Thanks for being my help with this show. Michael, I'm good. We have one final magic trick to share with you. At 5 o'clock, I will be at the Great Music Hall with our big show. It's called Rocklusions. If you haven't seen it, it's big illusions, big lights and sound. After the show, I'll be right here to take pictures if you'd like to take pictures. Amanda's going to come out, show up the jumping wands over here. They're only $5 if you'd like a little souvenir. And after pictures, anyone who gets one, I'll teach you how it jumps. But that's after this final trick with a couple of meagles. We simply call it the meagles. I'll come around to a couple of you and have you take a needle. Take a needle, drop it inside.
Make sure
it's real. Take a needle, drop it inside. Make sure
it's real. Kids, what I'm about to attempt is extremely dangerous, okay? So do not try this at home. Go to your friend's house. You can try it over there, okay? Much safer. Just take one needle.
Take one out and put it in your
mouth. Drop it right there inside. Yes, you got a couple more. Make sure they're real. Come up and finish up with the card. You can put them on to answer for it. One, two. This is the Rocklusions.
I'll get this. Some of this stuff I don't get. Perfectly good Gatorade too.
Thank you.